What's up, everyone? How's everybody doing tonight? So, I have a little announcement for everybody. And it's a big one. But before I get into that announcement, we're going to do it like this. And this might give you a hint as to what I'm getting at. Now, if y'all ain't figured it out yet, maybe this will give you an even better hint.
Gotta do the kick of destiny again.
What?
But this time, fans can pick if I'll make or miss.
What makes arcade tight is they have all these sounds for space. You know, it's just a bunch of cool sounds that you can play in between. Step they boundary.
Or, better yet, I got an even better one for you guys. Now, question. How many of you guys have been able to figure out what I'm getting at? How many of you guys have been able to pick back up and figure out what I'm getting at throughout these last few songs? How many of you guys have been able to figure that out? Because if you haven't been able to figure it out, well, this next one should make it pretty damn clear. Now, if you guys have not figured it out yet, allow me to explain it to you what's going on. As you guys know, I started my journey into sim racing back when I was 16. Back when I was 16, that's when I got my very first taste of what competitive racing can be on a gaming console. And over the years, I would go on to break several records, set several records, and get to compete with some of the best in the world, and get to meet some of the best in the world. Some of the people that I got to meet include people like the legendary Ken Block. Rest in peace to number 43. I would also go on to get to compete against people like the legendary YouTuber Slaptrain, who is honestly one of the best drivers within the Forza series on the face of this earth. The man's fucking good at what he does. But here lately, I've noticed a lot of people saying that, oh, he's not good, he sucks, he's this, he's that, blah, 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 blah. Well, we're about to do something about that. Starting tomorrow morning, not only on Forza Motorsport, not only on Dirt Rally Size, Dirt Rally 2.0, but also on F1 2023. Your boy is coming back behind the fucking driver's seat to show these motherfuckers what's up. Because far too long, I've had way too many people running their mouths, saying that I fell off, saying that I ain't got it, saying that I suck. They say that I still suck ass. They say that I ain't got it no more. But the truth is, how can I lose something that I never lost? Because that's the difference between me and people like these trolls that think they're good. I have the receipts to back up everything I say. These guys don't. And one of the reasons I decided to jump back in, after talking with my family about it, is because last year, in January, or not last year, but 2 years ago in January, I took two of the most important wins in my F1 career doing sim racing. The first one was on the 23rd, which is my older brother's birthday, the one who passed away. It was his birthday, and I took the win that day. But the most important two wins would come the next few days after. Next win I took was on the 31st, which is my mom's birthday. But the most important win of my life would come on February 3rd. When I would take the win out of a 3-day long race. And that day was the day that my older brother passed away. So for me, taking that win was the most important win in my whole fucking career. Those three wins were the most important wins in my life. And I find it funny how people always say, oh, you're no good, you suck, blah, 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 blah. You only do arcade stuff now, like, you're no pro, blah, blah, blah. Well, now that I'm in that position again, I can start to go pro again. Which means, all you trolls, you better fucking step aside. Because you're not getting acknowledged anymore. No negative people will be acknowledged anymore. And I will admit, you trolls did take a lot away from me. You did. You guys did take a lot away. But there's one thing you will never take away. And I think everybody here in the chat right now can agree with this. I think everybody right now in the chat can agree with what I'm about to say. If there's one thing you can't take away from me, it's my skill behind the fucking wheel. That is the one thing you will never be able to take away, is my skill behind the wheel. I mean, you guys have tried to shut me down, tried to put me off, but no more. I'm not only taking my career back, this time, I'm doing it the right way. And if anybody has a problem with what I'm doing, then screw you. Because I belong behind the wheel full on. Yeah, I may be good with games like Fortnite, Call of Duty, and all that stuff. That's true, I may be good, but my true skill lies behind the wheel. So to answer your question, yes. I am jumping back behind the wheel full fucking time. Am I still on Xbox? Yes, I am. And I'm gonna take it to the pro level? I'm hoping to get back there very soon. I don't know where the future is gonna take me. As far as this goes, but I can promise you this, I'm going to work my ass off every fucking day to get back to that level. Because anybody that's watched my career over the span of the last 11 years, when these trolls did what they did, I lost a lot. I lost careers. I lost sponsors. I lost quite a bit. But now that I'm not around that anymore, I can start to get those sponsors back. And believe me when I say, I'm gonna be working my motherfucking ass off on that shit for you guys. I can promise you guys this. I'm going to be working my ass off every day. Whether it's doing drift comps on Forza. Whether it's doing road racing on Motorsport. Or whether it's doing rally events on Dirt 2.0 or Dirt 5. Or F1 comps on F1 2023. Either way, I'm still going to be getting back to that point for you guys. Because I tell you right now, I missed being behind the wheel, man. I missed it. All last year, I was out. Not because anything was wrong with my setup or anything like that, no. I was out because I was depressed. And I was depressed because of what I was going through. I was sick, wasn't able to do nothing. And in a couple cases, I felt like I was at the end of my rope. I felt like my life was over at some point last year. But I made it to 2024, and this year, I can promise y'all, is going to be my year. Because not only am I doing this for my older brother, not only am I doing this for my OG fans that enjoy seeing me race, but I'm doing this for my fucking brothers, my team, that has been with me since day fucking one. Because I finally got to catch back up with them the other day. After several years of them being busy, life getting in the way. You know, life getting in the way. But I told them straight up that I will be getting back into comps full fucking force. And some of you that know me and have been around long enough, you guys might recognize our intro. Matter of fact, I know y'all that have been around long enough that have heard me mention these guys will know this intro. And to answer your question, it's very simple. Don't let it get the better of you. Find an excuse to win. Find that excuse to keep going. No matter what that excuse is, you find that excuse and you use it to help you overcome that shit. Cause that's what I did. I did what I had to do. And just like you, man, I was there, so I know. I understand what it's like. And I can tell you right now, I hope and pray to God that you get through it. Matter of fact, let me play you something that a friend of mine sent to me when I was in that position. I think it might help you. I'm glad you're still here, man. I hold the song. I hold the song that I'm about to do. I hope it helps you to keep fighting the same way that it did me, man. And I want you to know that not only am I here for you, everybody here in the chat is here for you as well, man. We got your back. I promise you that. You can reach out to any of us at any time. Myself or anyone here in the chat, man. We got your back. But this song made me realize that I need to keep going. And that I can't allow these demons to win. And neither should you. Don't let them win. Keep on fighting.
If you've ever accidentally deleted files,
that's the next one. I wanted to get this to not only my hero, Chester, who took his own life, but I want to dedicate this to everyone out there that's going through that same thing, or is at that point in their life. I want you guys to know that when you come here, you have a place that you can call home, whether it's here or whether it's on my YouTube channel. You guys have a home here. And I can promise you guys, no matter what, I will always, and I do mean always, be the light on for you.
At Take 5, you stay in your car because we're faster than you think.
Oil change is done.
That was so fast, I didn't even have time to finish knitting these sweaters. Oh, well.
Cheese!
I'm at my limit.
Let me tell you right now, man. You are great. Hell, I'm sure there's some stuff that you're good at that I'm not good at. Hell, I'm sure there's stuff that you're fucking amazing at that most people can't do. So yes, you are great. You're great in your own way. And don't let anybody ever tell you any fucking different, man. Because you are awesome. And if they hate on you for that, then fuck them. Matter of fact, let me share with you a pledge that I took several years ago when I was in the midst of all this. And this pledge I'm about to share with you guys, I want you guys to remember this pledge. And I want you guys, if you can, to take this pledge with me. For me, this will be my second time.
I'm always looking for new ways to expand people's perspective of the world, like my animated series.
Therapy, for me, came at a time that was really pivotal. Becoming a new father, I needed more support. I have an extensive...
155,000 around...
If you've ever accidentally deleted files...
And to answer your question... To answer your question, Turn? No, I'm not. Because by defending myself against them, I'm in turn giving them a reaction. If I do not give them a reaction, they have nothing. If I do not react, they have nothing left. And they get starved out. You see what I'm saying? If I defend myself, that's giving them a reaction. And I'm not going to react to them anymore. Now, this mentality I'm about to show you guys, I want y'all to have the same mentality when fighting whatever it is that you're dealing with. Because I know things might seem dark now, but if you adapt, this mentality, there's no way you can lose.
The thing I love about surfing is it never stops challenging you. It's a journey through the waves, but also through your very soul.
These nuggets...
Not what I needed. Now, if any of you guys want to reach out to me, right there is my email. Oh, and to Amy. Let me reply to you real quick. Now, if y'all want to reach out to me, you guys can. And Amy, I did send you my my gamer tag. But if you guys want to reach out to me, you guys can reach me by email anytime there, now, man. I know it takes a while to respond back to emails, but that's because, well, you know, I've had a lot of shit going on trying to get back to being myself again. But now that I'm in a good spot, I can start answering emails again. But with that being said, man, I love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the morning, man. I'm about to crash for the night because I am fucking tired out. Because I did a lot of getting ready today for the future and shit I'm going to be doing. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you guys did, y'all already know what to do. And don't forget, you guys can see me over on YouTube daily. I'll be doing videos over there. I'll be doing live streams over there on the daily. Every day, I'll be over there. So you guys can catch me over there. If you do not have, and I do mean if you do not have my YouTube channel, I will post it right now so I can get to my channel real quick. But right here is my channel where you guys can hang out, have a good time. I got a couple shorts over there made by a really cool fan. And I got like one video up right now and like a crap ton of lives. So if you did miss any live streams, I have a few of them over there for y'all to catch up on. So yeah. With that being said, then, I love you guys. And I'll see y'all in the morning, man. As always, stay humble, stay positive, keep being yourself. And if anybody talks shit to you, man, fuck them. Because you're better than they are, man. And I want you guys to remember one thing, man. No matter what you're going through, there is light at the end of the tunnel. You just gotta keep going and pushing, man. That's the best thing you can do. Keep fighting and never give up on yourself. If anything, never give up on yourself. Keep pushing forward no matter what. I love you guys. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.